As promised, joining me today, I'm very excited to talk to David Springate. He is the technical director for Dirt 5. David, how are you today?
I'm very well, thank you, Larry. How are you?
I am absolutely splendid. I have to tell you, I'm very excited to talk to you. You know, you guys had a great series of announcements at Inside Xbox. Gee whiz, it was last month. And I want to talk about that, but let's talk about what you've announced already, and then we're going to talk some more about Dirt 5.
Sure. So Dirt 5 is an incredibly exciting racing game. So at Codemasters, we exclusively make racing games, and we make some very hardcore racing games. We're really after that hardcore player. We're after that person that really loves shaving time off their time trials. But Dirt 5 is for someone that wants to chill on the sofa. They want to grab a controller, right, sit with their friends, have a great time, and have a great visual experience. Mm-hmm. So Dirt 5 has split screen. It makes the most of the power of Xbox Series X. It has a lot of surprises coming in the next few months. So I'm very excited when we're going to be talking more about that. But really, it's a racing game, an off-road racing game that's thinking about how do we take racing but make it, turn it up to 11 in the fun. How do we make it so that everybody has a big smile in there when they're racing around, enjoying great music, great visuals, and a great gameplay experience?
Now, I want to start off by talking. We got a lot to talk about, but I want to start off with you as the technical director. Tell us a little bit about your journey to become the technical director of Dirt 5. That'd be great.
Okay. So I've been working at Codemasters now for about 3.5 years. I started at the studio as principal graphics programmer. So that means I come from a very nerdy background. I've only ever worked in video game engine development.
That is
so
nerdy.
I'm all about it. It is very nerdy. So I've only ever worked thinking about performance and visuals. How do we make a beautiful game? But I'm very fortunate in that we're surrounded by incredibly talented people like our design and art teams. And as you know, any video game is a collection of a large group of people, incredibly talented people coming together to make a great collaborative effort. So, yeah, that's really my story. I've come from a nerdy background and just rose up to lead the team. And I have an incredible team. I'm very thankful for them.
Yeah, I mean, because technical director is you kind of touch all parts of it. I mean, there's the creative side that wants to execute on a vision, and your job is to look at the technical side and say, can we meet that and maybe come up with some ideas? That's what I've always loved about video games. And for 15 years, I've been talking about this, how I love how the technical side and the creative side, they have to come together and work in concert. And so you're kind of sitting at the nexus of that, aren't you?
Yeah, and I guess video game development is primarily, in my experience, and I've been working in video games for 13 years, video game development is about healthy argument. It's about kicking around ideas and saying, how are we going to deliver this?
Yeah.
Everybody wants to deliver a great video game. Everybody wants to make something fun, but how are we going to get it to work on this hardware? How are we going to make it as beautiful as we can? How are we going to maintain incredible frame rates? There's always a lot of healthy discussion. And I think that given that we work, and obviously I'm very fortunate to work in video games.
Yeah, we are.
But given that we work hard like everybody else, it's very important, because I spend more time with my work colleagues when we're able to be in the office, obviously not nowadays. But when we were able to be in the office, I was spending more time with my colleagues than with my family. So it's very important that we get on. It's very important that you can have healthy debate and discussion and move past those things and just make decisions and crack on, be a great team together, seeking to strive and incredible to make a great video game.
Yeah, I mean, it's interesting because as you said, you've been in the business for quite some time as well as I, and you've seen teams go from, you know, there's the indie devs that are one or two folks to smaller teams, which are 5 to 100. And now they're, you know, some studios, I don't know how many people you have working in your studio, but I've seen studios with thousands of people. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
Yeah. And that means that it's very hard to be able to figure out what are the right moves. How do you keep all of the different plates spinning? How do you bring them all together on time? What do you do when things are failing? What are your backup measures? All that stuff. It is very difficult to juggle all of those plates. But we are doing a great job at Cheshire Studios. So I'm very, very proud of the team.
All right, let's get into it, because Dirt 5, we talked about it, was announced last month at Inside Xbox, coming to Xbox Series X. I want to talk to you about that, because it is, what excites you about developing and bringing Dirt 5 to life on next generation hardware?
So as a video game fan, it's a very exciting day when new hardware comes out. Like a lot of video game fans, I've queued for consoles, I've had them pre-ordered on day one, and you're hoping that it's going to come a day early and all that kind of stuff. And it's no different for game developers, that when hardware turns up at the studio, it's a very exciting day. So I remember when Project Scorpio hardware, as it was called back then, when it turned up at the studio, obviously it turns up with my name on all of the boxes, which
sure.
That does not get old. And so all of these kids turn up, and I grab some of the younger guys on the team, and I say, hey, you wanna come downstairs to the IT department and see the new Xbox?
Right.
And their faces are like, wow,
It's like Christmas morning, right?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And so to answer your question, what am I excited about developing for Series X? All of it. All of it. So all of the hardware features that we're looking at, it's like being a kid in a candy shop. You're looking at all of these toys and thinking, how am I going to make great use of these features in our game? Thinking about things like ray tracing, fast storage, low latency input, variable rate shading, all of that nerdy stuff. How do I translate that into being a fun, great experience for the fans, for the consumers?
That feels next gen. You talked a little bit about that, about quicker loading times, which of course Xbox Series X will have. But when you look at the features that we've announced, what are some of the other ones that get you excited, especially Dirt 5? Is it ray tracing? Because that's something that a lot of folks are excited about.
Yeah, a lot of people want to talk about ray tracing. Yeah. So as a team, we're looking at everything. I can't commit to everything yet, Larry, but and ray tracing is one of those features.
Yeah.
I can't commit to everything, but we're definitely looking into everything.
Right.
But for me, the mere strength of the console was something that just blew me away as soon as I started working with it.
Yeah.
So one of the things that isn't talked about as much about Series X is simultaneous multi-threading. So that's not one of those sexy features like ray tracing that people are going to talk about on their blog yeah. posts the most, but the CPU is a beast.
Yeah.
It really is a beast. And you have to have the right engine that's geared up to make use of that many processors. And we're fortunate enough to be in a position that we do. So when I enabled that feature, Dirt 5 just sprang to life on Series X. And it was amazing. I called people over from across the office, come check this out.
Right.
Because it was running amazing straight away. So all of the features, we've talked a little about 120 hertz.
Yeah, 120 or 120 frames per second, right? Right, 120 frames per second.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, 120 frames per second. Now, that's a challenge.
Yeah.
And a lot of people were very surprised that we were able to talk about that. That means that you need to hit a frame rate where the frame has to be rendered in under 8.3 milliseconds, which is very quick. There's going to have to be some compromises to make it to 120 hertz, because obviously we've got an incredibly beautiful game at 60 frames per second on Series X.
Right.
How are we going to make it be just as fun at half the time, 120 frames per second? So we've already got that up and running, but we're thinking about, well, how are we going to make this work across the game, the whole game? That's the goal. I don't know if we're going to make it that far, but we're looking at the different options that are available to us. But of course, we'll be supporting new HDMI 2.1 features that are in Series X, like FreeSync 2. Variable rate shading is on the GPU as well, but variable refresh rates, and of course, everything that comes along with the new visual improvements. Yeah.
I think it's important to point out, and I'll link off to the YouTube, the trailer on YouTube, on the Xbox channel on YouTube. But with Dirt 5, I mean, you've got this amazing CPU, because and you kind of alluded to it earlier. with next gen, it's not just about fast read write speed, which of course Xbox Series X had, but it's the entire, as you engineers would say, the pipeline, right? It's making sure the CPU and all of these things are there to really give this next gen experience. So it's really important to look at all parts of the puzzle. Would you say that that's accurate?
Oh, completely. And even then, it's not as simple as just the NVMe drive in Series X is fast. Oh boy, is it fast. But what am I going to do with the other pieces of the puzzle as well? So we can have data using hardware decompression. So we compress our data like textures and things like that while we're building the game at the office and writing that to your disk. And that means that we can decompress it in the hardware as it's loaded for basically for free.
Right.
So that means I can get even faster throughput than what the NVMe drive can deliver. So it's a beast. I've got no other way of putting it. It's really, really fast. But yeah, that means that we're able to deliver better, more beautiful experiences than we could before.
Yeah.
And that excites me. That I'm thinking, how now that I have all of these tools laid out for me on the table, how do I make use of all of these features to deliver an amazing video game, an amazing experience for the gamers?
You know, one question I get asked a lot, but I'm not a developer, so I won't even answer it. I'm not nowhere near qualified like you. But what is it like developing on Xbox Series X?
Sure. So anytime new hardware comes out, it's usually a very, very painful experience. When hardware shows up, it's usually half finished, or it crashes a lot, and the API, the programming tools that we use, then usually not finalized, or even worse, they can suddenly change halfway through development.
Right.
And so suddenly you're having to pivot really quickly. But actually, Series X has been a very smooth experience. So Microsoft have developed something that they call the Game Development Kit, which is a new replacement and actually is going to be utilized on original Xbox One and Xbox One S and Xbox One X. And that's how everything is going to be developed together, a unified product development all the way from Xbox One up to Series X, but making the most of the hardware features across the board. But there are actually benefits to that as well. So an Xbox One game that was developed before now could now perform better if it was made with the new game development kit. It also has the ability to make use of low latency input, which is really, really important for a racing game. And I'm a big fan of fighting games, so I'm looking forward to some of those coming out on Series X and making most of that too. But all in all, development on Series X has been more of the same, but just allowing me to stop and say, okay, My day-to-day tool set has not changed that much. It's still that familiar Xbox One experience, but now I get to make the most of all of the new toys.
Yeah, and I think that's important to point out, David, is that, you know, you said that it's much of the same, and that's not a bad thing. It's much of the same because it allows you to understand the tools better, and then your workflow is faster and so forth, right?
Yeah, in fact, it's the best thing. I don't want new tools. I want to make the most of the experience that I already have. I want to make the most of understanding how to get to the hardware, not having new tools blocking me from getting in the way of getting to that hardware. So having familiar tools, having a familiar interface, super important. So it's been a really smooth transition for us at Cheshire Studio making Dirt 5.
One of the things you talked about was, you know, the tools being similar and easy to work with, and how Xbox One owners or Xbox One is going to get see some lift from this. That kind of brings me to the next question about smart delivery for your game and what it means for Dirt 5 fans. Tell us a little bit about how you see it, since you're there working on it right now.
Sure. So one of the things that, as a consumer, I enjoy is the ability to take my Xbox library from one Xbox console and have it just be seamless.
Right.
So when I'm playing Minecraft Dungeons on my Xbox One X downstairs, if I can't get the TV that evening, I need to play upstairs in my study on my Xbox One S. My save's coming with me. My purchase is coming with me. It's not something I need to worry about.
It just works.
And that's different. Yeah, it just works. That's what we want as a consumer. I just want it to work. Now, of course, I want it to just work with Dirt 5, with Xbox Series X. So smart delivery allows us to say, hey, you want to buy Dirt 5 on your Xbox One? When you upgrade to Series X, whenever that may be launch day, it may be a year after, you'll have Dirt 5. It will be there. You'll get it, the Series X experience. It will just upgrade for free. You'll get all of those great hardware benefits. You'll get the rendering upgrades, the performance, everything. It will just come over. And your save will come too. You'll still be able to play with the friends that you'd made on Xbox One. Everybody plays together. That's it. It's as simple as that. So for me, as a gamer, smart delivery is fantastic, but also a no-brainer. It's not something I'm hoping in years to come, we're not going to talk about this because this is just...
Yeah,
it's obvious.
It's funny. It's kind of like, you know, back in the day, 10 years ago or a little bit more maybe, where people were excited about touchscreens on a phone. But now you don't talk about that anymore because it's just every phone has a touchscreen, right? It's just like, of course it does. So it feels like this is one of those things that people are going to, once they understand, they're going to, oh, okay. But then eventually it's just going to fade and become part of what is expected of a next-gen gaming experience, right?
Yeah, exactly. And my friends are saying to me, so if I get an Xbox Series X, because obviously like anybody else that's really into video games, we all have those friends that ask the questions of
we're the
big gamer.
We're the experts, right?
Right. Yeah. And they say to me, if I buy a Series X, will my Xbox One games work? Will they come over? And I'm, yeah, of course they will. And anything that you have on Xbox 360 on back compat, that's going to come with you too.
Yeah.
So if you have Dirt 2 available on back compat, which it is, you can take that onto your Xbox One, of course, and it can come with you onto Xbox Series X if you still want to enjoy that game.
Yeah, it's funny you say that because I've always asked our engineers, I'm like, hey, because you can't really see all the games you've played in terms of the saves. And I would love to say, hey, show me what my oldest save is. Because I remember when I picked up, I think it was GTA a few months ago. I was playing GTA on back compat. And having that come in and just to see that last time I played it was 2011 or something like that. It was like, wow, it just really... everything else just kind of melts away, and it's fascinating. It's almost a little bit of a time capsule. You've been talking a lot about, David, as the technical director, you've been talking a lot about Dirt 5 and Xbox Series X. But tell us a little bit more about the game itself and what gamers can expect from Dirt 5 in terms of the locations and the gameplay and so forth. You kind of hinted a little bit at the beginning, but let's go a little bit deeper on that.
So there's something very specific that I want to talk about. The thing that really makes me smile when I play Dirt 5. So obviously we've got a huge ton of cars. They come from loads of different types of vehicle. So we have super lights and rock bouncers and all kinds of crazy things. This is a real collection of off-road racing. In fact, we have this one car, a sprint car. It can only turn left. And all of the wheels are different sizes. And that means it's got a really crazy handling experience.
It's something you've never done before, because you can't really do that in real life.
Well, I remember talking about it with the guys. I mean, it is a real car, but right. I remember talking about it with the guys in the studio. They said to me, yeah, we want to do this sprint car thing. And they talked me through it. And I said, what? This sounds crazy and weird, but I really got to check it out. And so the tracks are all in an oval, and you think that sounds simple, and it is not. It is a very interesting experience.
So David, I have to tell you, here in the United States, we have something called NASCAR, and you're kind of describing that to a certain degree, but I'm sure it's a little bit more than that, right?
It's very, very different from NASCAR, very different. And at first start, it's off-road, very, very dusty going around these ovals and all of your sprint cars being very closely packed together, much like NASCAR, but the experience is so much more visceral in my experience. But yeah, we have a breadth of off-road experiences, different terrains, different surface types to race on, but it's weather that really gets me excited.
Ah, okay.
And I know that's a strange thing to talk about in a video game about cars, but it's the weather. So not only do we have full day, night cycle, all that kind of stuff, the race can change from day to night. But I was playing the game today and I'm driving through the streets in Norway, and lightning bolts are going off in the background in the night, huge flashes of lightning, and you see the lightning striking in front of you. And we have very complex weather system that allows us to do lots and lots of interesting things. And I'm worried that I'm saying too much, so I don't want to get into too much detail on this, but I know that we're going to be covering it in the months to come. But weather allows us to have different experiences every time you play the five.
Sure.
And it allows us to change the experience whenever we feel like it as developers. So we can give you new experiences in those places whenever we like.
Right.
And it's a bit like having a timeline, setting up a bunch of events within a single race. When do we want it to strike lightning? When do we want it to snow? When do we want it to rain? All of that kind of stuff. And that allows a really interesting experience. So that's one of the ways that we're turning the game up to 11 on Dirt 5. And I really cannot wait for people to see it.
Yeah, it's. I know that when we saw the trailer, and again, I'll link off to the trailer, I remember watching the trailer and I kind of stopped. I mean, I've seen hundreds of game trailers and thousands in my day, but I remember just stopping and looking at this, and I just, my word, it looked, the lighting looked beautiful. I mean, all the stuff that we've kind of been talking about in theory came into, and I know this is just a trailer and I haven't even seen the real game yet, but it felt so good. And that was in-engine capture. That was gameplay capture, right?
Absolutely. 100%. So I want to be really, really clear on this.
Yeah.
There was no shenanigans in the trailer. Nothing. Nothing was faked. Nothing was touched up. There was, in fact, I want to be 100% honest. There's one thing that we didn't do in-engine in the video. There's this corruption-looking graffiti transition between camera shots. That was it. The only thing. And that's for a video effect. That's not game footage or anything like that.
Yeah, that was really just everything for the trailer itself. But as far as the actual game footage, was actual game footage.
Game footage. That is all captured completely in engine, nothing faked. And I am so proud to be able to say that. I've worked on games before where you have to, you know, fudge some stuff, fake some things, because you've got trailers, and getting trailers done before you finish the game, that's hard.
Sure.
It's really, really hard. But actually the team, they work really hard. They love what they do and they're great at it. So they're nailing it. They're absolutely nailing it.
So you mentioned a little, I know I gotta let you go here. We've been going on for quite some time, but you've got some more information coming up in the future. Maybe I'll have you back on the show if you'd like to do that.
Oh, that would be wonderful.
But why don't you give us all the details on when Dirt 5 is coming out and the platforms and so on and so forth. So here's your chance to sell it again.
So Dirt 5 is obviously coming to Xbox Series X, but don't forget, with smart delivery, it's available on every Xbox platform. We'll be bringing the game out around the holiday season. We're nailing down some information on that yet, but I'm sure that you can find out more over our Twitter, which is @DirtGame. If you have any questions, of course, you can ping me directly @DavidSpringate on Twitter. But yeah, we've got a lot more surprises coming up. Some really, really big back of the box features, stuff that's going to surprise and entertain people. And I'm really looking forward to seeing what you think of this, Larry.
I appreciate it.
So keep your eyes peeled. We've put our roadmap out of what we're announcing when, but there's a big question mark on our roadmap. And I'm super excited to show that. So keep your eyes open.
We look forward to it. David Springate, the technical director for Dirt 5. Appreciate you taking the time today. I know you're joining us from the UK, so it's a little later there than my day. So I'll let you get back to your family time. And thanks again, and we look forward to hearing more information.
Thanks, Larry. Thanks for having me on the show.